We will now see the 14th title of law as stated in Narad Smriti. Now what is this 14th title of law? Heinous offences. I think now we are shifting our discussion from civil to criminal because we are entering offences zone. So let us see what are there. Four kinds of heinous offences. Manslaughter, that is murder, robbery, assault and abuse. This all four kind of offences we can see identically in today's Indian Penal Code. Indian Penal Code covers them. Now what are the next? 3 degrees of heinous offences. Now he has given 3 different degrees for offences. Now what is that? First, middle and highest. We follow this but not in so many clear words. Like when we say rarest of rarest, it's actually we are trying to do the degree to that particular offence. Now, first and second degree means what? Destroying, injuries, etc. Now we have something same today like section 323 or section 324 of Indian Penal Code. They are like first degree or second degree kind of an offences which are not extremely heinous, but yes, they are milder, but they are still offences. Then we have third degree means what? It's obviously the highest category and that's called murder. Now we'll see punishments. First degree, second degree. For both of this, there is only fine. For third degree, because it's actually a murder, corporal, that is death sentences. Even today, we have similar kind of a corporal punishment for death or for heinous crimes. Now there is something more, or amputation of limb with which crime is committed. Now this is that eye for an eye, hand for an hand. So that particular kind of an punishment we have abolished today, as we have slightly become more civilized and we have eliminated that. So the amputation is not there. Corporal is there. But even today, there are discussions going on as regarding the death sentences. Because there are various countries in the world who have actually abolished death sentences. Then, thieves are not caught. Then, king must make good the loss. Now this is where the governance of king comes into picture. Eka jarka rajyamadhe chori zali asel, to chor sapadla nasel, kiwa ti vastu sapadli nasel, tar rajyani ti vastu bharun kadayachi. Today we don't have any such kind of an provision wherein if the thieves are not found, if a robbery is done and robbers are not caught, the government is going to compensate. Now this particular aspect shows us that how the entire society was connected with the king. King acted like a father of that society. Ki tya society madhe kodalahi problem hoon nahi, kodalahi tras hoon nahi. Ani zar ka tya society madhe ekadala tras zala, ani raja cha asakshamte mule जर तो चोर किंवा ते आर्टिकल रिकवर नाही होऊ शकलं तर राजा स्वतः ते कंपेन्सेट करायचा. दिस पर्टिक्युलर आस्पेक्ट इज नॉट देअर नाव. सो ॲक्च्युली स्पीकिंग द गव्हर्नन्स डन बाय किंग वॉज ॲक्च्युली मच गुड अँड मच नाईस कम्पेअर्ड टू द प्रेझेंट गव्हर्नमेंट्स गव्हर्नन्स.